Pizza God. Good morning. We're continuing this morning in our teaching series, Understanding, Receiving, and Activating the Power of God. My Lord, I declare the devil don't want this word to get out, and he really don't want you to get it. But what he wants to do is bound you up in fear, bound you up in intimidation, bound you up in doubt, bind you up in sin. He want to bind you up and make you remain a mere man. Glory be to God, as if you're retarded and can't get this word. But this is your opportunity. This is your season and your moment. And you need to seize the moment with everything you got. My Lord, the Bible says we're going to give an account for every deed, every thought, every word, every intention, every opportunity that we took lightly. Glory be to God. And we didn't take the invitation that God has brought for us to bring us out of where we are to where we need to be. Every invitation that we've denied and rejected and looked at as if it was nothing, we got to give an account to that one day. And so somebody needs to open up their heart, glory be to God, and you need to really tell on yourself. You need to examine yourself to see if you're in the faith. See if this word is doing you any good after 40 years of hearing it. See if by now you done change, my Lord. Even if you sat in under the word for a good 6 months, you still ought to be done changed something, glory to God. My Lord, when the power of this word, that like a two-edged sword, it cuts going in and it cuts you going out. That means it's rooting out and plucking up and removing all those things that hold you captive. But if you're not changing, something's wrong with you. There's nothing wrong with the word. Don't get this twisted. There's nothing wrong with this word. Say with me, there's nothing wrong with the word of God.
There's nothing wrong with the word of God.
The problem is me.
The problem is me.
So when we don't receive the word and we don't allow the word to be in us, then it's not God's fault. Glory be to God. We got to understand when you walk contrary to this word, you ain't just hurting yourself, but you're hurting the people you attached to. It's time for us to stop hurting the people that we're attached to.
Amen.
And come up together. Amen?
Amen.
Glory be to God. It's time for our motives and our intentions to be pure. Amen. And lived out loud in a way that we can really understand where each other is coming from.
Amen.
Tell the truth on yourself.
Yes.
My Lord.
Amen.
Tell the truth on yourself and folk can appreciate the truth.
Yes.
My Lord. Yes. The Bible says you reap what you sow. So you become a trickster and you get tricked.
Yeah.
So we need to let this word be Lord over us. So we can stop the foolishness in the kingdom. Stop the madness. And we can really see what this word is saying to each of us. My Lord, did you get this word one time on Sunday morning? How about it slap me over and over again? From the time he give it to me until I give it out until after that. I'm hearing it over and over again, and it's all good. I don't care how much it's hitting me and it cutting me, but it's still good. The Bible styled the word of God as a medicine. And so if you don't take your medicine, glory be to God, then you can't be healed. Your sin-sick soul will never come out. You will always be hiding and think you're getting away, and you'll get away with anything. Why? Because God see everything. I'm not interested in what y'all see me do. I'm interested in what God see me do.
Amen.
What he knows about me. I'm not trying to impress anybody. I'm not interested in impressing anybody. I really ain't, to be honest with you. I need to please God. And so in pleasing God, my faith is attached to that. So this morning, we're continuing in our exercise, our spiritual authority as sons of Abraham. And we're getting ready to get into some deep stuff. And it's some hard stuff. And I say that because flesh do not want to bow to this word. I'm going to tell you the truth. Your flesh do not want to hear this. If you got any issues, you do not want to hear this word. Well, there it is. Well, some of us got issues and we want to come out. So it's like the cutting is welcome, is what I'm saying to you. Cut me, Lord. Cut me. Let me help me get myself right. I want to be right. Some people want to be right, and they genuinely want to be right. My Lord, guess who to know? Guess who will be the first one to know you want to be right? You. You know. So we are in this topic talking about the test of your faith. Even though we're going to talk about Abraham, but how about this ain't about him? This is about you. He is just used as an example. And so in this, the first part of this teaching about testing in your faith, which we know is going to be a hard place for self, because self don't want to bow. Self don't want to fast. Self don't want to be corrected. Self don't want to pray. Self want to go about and tay in the wind and do his own thing. Don't you know this is about me? No, it's not about you. It's about killing you. That's what it's about. So in this pursuit of exercising our faith and being ready for the test, it's nothing more powerful than being ready for a test.
That's right.
Yeah. When you're ready for a test, then you're not afraid. Mm-hmm. Intimidation, now, all that stuff is out of the window. I done been tested in that. Mm-hmm. I done went through that. I know what it means to serve people that don't like me. I know what it means to love my neighbor. I know what it means to go beyond the call of duty. I know what it means if my peace is not received, knock the dust off my feet. And let it return to me. And love them anyway. I know what that means. I've been tested in that. Did you know your entire life is your test? What you gonna do with it? What you do with it will determine what grade you get it. Now, Lord, it's time for the church to stop failing. It's time for us to stop failing. Remember what you're attached to. Glory be to God. You bring that which you're attached to. If you are not willing to get right in this word, you just taint everything you touch. So you need to throw that out of your mindset. Oh, I ain't hurt nobody. I ain't doing this. Ain't nobody know about it. I ain't hurting nobody. Yes, you're hurting everybody who you're attached to.
Amen.
Some are suffering for other folk junk.
Amen. Yeah.
And it makes me upset to know that I can suffer for somebody else. Mm-hmm. Yes, you can. Mm-hmm. Why? Because we're connected, the entire body of Christ.
Yeah.
Every joint supply. Yeah. When you see your brother in error and you don't correct him, you will suffer along with him. You become an enabler of his issue. God revealed that thing to you. He showed you that thing. That was your test to see. If you're willing to suffer, to be talked about, to be ridiculed, to possibly be left and abandoned, rejected, are you going to still tell them the truth? Oh, yeah, I ain't going to say nothing to them because you know what? They ain't going to like me like they don't like the mother folk they got on their list. I ain't want to get on their bad list, so I'm just going to wink at their mess. You're going to suffer with their mess too. I believe God holds us directly accountable when we are enablers and we don't pull people out of the fire of hell with truth. I myself got to turn up the heat, just like Christ went into the temple and whipped them out because they was in the church. How many knows your body is a temple? It is the church. The Holy Ghost resides. You got to get ugly. You got to get violent and say, you know what, you devil, you lust, you better get up off my mind.
Amen.
You thief, get up off me. You hatred, get up, jealous. I hear you talking about behind my back. What?
Yeah.
That's your test.
Glory.
And are you going to believe what you do? God becomes pleased with it.
Yeah.
You need your faith to do it. Yeah. That is okay when you follow the word of God. When you follow wisdom and love. Glory to God. A real friend, I love you for correcting them. But somebody that's a hypocrite, they're imposters. When you tell them the truth, you know what they're going to do? Run from you.
They'll hate you most.
And that is your acid test to let you know that they ain't want it. They ain't want to work real anyway. I don't need friends that gonna stroke me. I don't need you to come and tell me something to make me feel good. You need to tell me the truth. And I can work with the truth. But don't lie to me. And you know I was wrong. And then you lie to me. Instead of you helping me out, you enable me. So all this is embodied into the test of faith. Are you going to go and do God? You know what, God? The hardest test, I ain't going to get ahead of myself. We're going to get into that hard test. And how much it's going to cost you, your emotions, to shut it down, to obey God. So your faith is one of the most vital components that you have. All those seven things that we talked about. How many things was it? Six or seven that we talked about? The benefits. And one of the main ones is to please God. It'll cause you to please God. That's how vital this thing is. And your salvation, of course. What you do with your faith will be the determining factor in what you receive. You reap what you sow. You sow sin, sin you again. You sow the word in your heart, righteousness, and the character of God is what you will get. So what you choose to do with it, your faith, if you choose to do nothing and allow the word to not penetrate your mind, and it rolls off your ears and your soul like water on a duck's back, and you choose not to do it, nothing you'll get. And so life is full of opportunities. I believe we got in talking about opportunity. Knowing how to embrace an opportunity could work for you or against you. And I say for you because it's a moment. It's an opportunity. It's a moment of great joy. It'll work for you knowing how to embrace it. And I know how to embrace it because this thing look hard, but how about I'm going to obey God? This thing look beyond me, but how about I'm going to obey God? This is trouble. This trouble, I know that if I obey God, it might bring me more trouble, but I'm going to obey God. Because I understand it's a moment of great joy. Remember we talked about that? And yet it can work against you when the opportunity of faith comes and how you embrace it. Because you can embrace it in fear. And you can embrace it. You know what God told Jesus told God told Moses to speak to the rock, and what he did, there was an opportunity. He smoked it. So the opportunity that he embarked upon, he used the wrong method. Frustration was the method that he used. He allowed the frustration that he suffered to be acted out from his soul to his hand. And he smote the rock. Then understand that when you smite something God told you to be a part of, or whatever the case may be, and you don't handle that thing right, you hitting Jesus. He said, what you do to the least of these, you do it, you done it unto me. So you're indirect. You gotta know that it can work for you or against you. So wisdom and knowledge is very important, my Lord. Remember, in our last teaching, we talked about fear being the consequences of that test can bring. Like I say, with Moses, it was frustration that caused him to do it. And so sometimes God sends opportunity, and because it does not play out as we want it to play out, you know, this ain't the way I see this. This ain't the way I plan this. I tell you, God don't always work. God will give you something, but he don't always work the way you planned it. And the way you've seen it. Amen. I've gotten so much experience of that till it's just crazy. Really? I'm like, wow, Lord, I ain't mean to do that, but this is what I'm saying. So we work against God, and then we abort his divine will for our lives, because that thing don't, it looks like a, you know, the Bible talks about Jesus and the way he looked. There's no beauty or comeliness. He don't look good. He was despised and rejected. So that thing didn't look good, you know. Serving and you know, working with the children, that don't look too good. Lord, you mean telling me you want me to go back in and work with the little ones?
Yeah.
Lord, you want me to be on the usher? You want me to usher? Ain't no glory in usher. Lord, you mean telling me you want me to do what? You want me to talk to the little, you want me to go out there and talk to the guys under the tree? But this thing under there, no. I'm just trying to make sure you know what you said to me. So we abort his divine plan and understand that your blessing was right there where he told you to go. That's what it was. You know he said go, but you ain't understand where. That's where he said go, not down to that tree. That's what it is. Everything you do is a test of your faith. And so it's not a signal for you to run. Well, this look too hard. Sometimes the test come and we do what? Tell and run. God, you mean tell me you want me to do it? Ain't you crazy? And so why? Because that thing looks too big. It's beyond us. And it is. That's why Christ told us, apart from me, you can't do nothing. Act like you got amnesia. You forget me and your going up if you want them. I know you done made it, and you know you're shining a little bit here. Forget me if you want them. You're going to shipwreck your own self.
Real quick.
So it's not a signal, but rather it's an opportunity for us to experience what? Great joy. Remember we talked about that last week? Your test of faith adds up to trouble. Just let that sink in. Well, every time I turn around, drama going on over here, drama going on. You know what I look at drama right now? This is good. You look at lack, this is good. You look at your frustration, this is good. Why? Because I got another thing to give unto the master. If you give it to another, you crazy. How you gonna give somebody something that they got the same thing you got? So you ought to be giving it to God and God alone. Remember, he's Lord. And so he's in Lord. And since he's Lord, well, he's in control. Let's go to the book, James. We started out in James. We used the James, the first chapter, the second through the fourth verse, to talk about the testing of our faith. And we're getting ready. I need you to lower that a little bit more, Mark Kennedy. The AC. Yes. So we're using James to talk about this test, that this hard place that we've never been before, this unfamiliar place. As sons of Abraham, we got to be willing to do it all. We can't be on the right side. We just wanted the blessing. God just give me Jimmy. Like the prodigal son, don't give me nothing. Don't try to scold me. Don't try to tell me I ain't ready for this. Just give it to me. I want it now. But yet I don't want to submit under the authority of nobody. I just want to be paying to win it on my own. Sin. Dear brothers, we talked about, and sisters in James, when trouble comes your way, consider it an opportunity for great joy. For we know that when your faith is tested, your endurance has a chance to grow. And then 4th verse says, so let it grow. For when your endurance is fully developed, you will be perfect and complete and needing nothing. And that's what we start sort of like in that third verse. We said, for when your, I want to talk about that a little bit more before we go to the fourth verse. When your faith is tested, your endurance has a chance to grow. And so your endurance, we talked about a little bit, will not have chance to grow until your faith has been challenged. And when we say challenge, we're talking about a test. So let's fall in love with this. Let's fall in love with challenges. Let's fall in love with folk getting on our nerve and misunderstanding us and all that. All that, that's just a test.
Amen.
I can't be developed. I can't be fortified in God until I get run up into some misunderstanding.
That's right.
I need that.
Amen.
What are you talking about?
Amen.
If I was up in glory, I wouldn't need none of that.
Uh-huh.
I need to miss it sometime.
My God.
Well, help me, Jesus.
Yes.
And I need to be able to say I missed it that time.
Yes.
Oh, don't, that's what communication relationship is all about. I offended you that time. I'm so sorry.
Yeah.
Instead of saying, "No, I know. Oh, you ain't a. You are. I'm. You're. Stop lying." And let's come clean with each other, to where we can really be able to really gel together in a way that God is pleased with.
Amen.
My Lord. So we said that your endurance is your staying power, and it must have a chance for survival. God is giving us a chance for survival in these days, in these last days. He's given, he said, the day you hear my voice, don't harden your heart. He's calling in souls right now today. Come to the Lord now before the end. He's given us a chance to be able to live in this earth. He's given us a chance to strengthen our resolve and cause our endurance.
Thank you,
to cause us to be able to go up instead of being stagnant on God. Instead of going back on God. He's given us another chance. Anytime we have a moment to hear the word, he's given us another chance. To strengthen ourselves. Anytime we can sit and understand what worship and what prayer and what thanksgiving and what gratitude means, he's given us another chance. Anytime we can take a moment and be our brother's keeper and serve and love on each other and stand in the gap, he's given us another chance. Everything you do, whether you do it for yourself or another, it's a chance to strengthen your endurance. You're working, you're always working on something. Every time you exercise and move your arm, it's giving your muscles a chance. Build muscles, eat protein. Protein build muscle. And muscle do what? Burn fat. You want muscle? Get some of that fat off your body. Just the way it works in the spiritual and the natural, it works in the body. So we can understand that. So we're working out our soul salvation. So if you're intending on finishing this race, you really better get this. That's if we, just in case you want to finish it well. You know what the word say? The race is not given to the swift or the strongest or the smartest or the one that seem to always have it together. Because some of them going to miss. But it's given to them who is willing to hold out and endure to the end. The Bible say the same shall be saved. So just in case you intend on seeing God in peace, you might want to strengthen your endurance. Your endurance is your stamina, which is your resilience. It's your flexibility. It's your toughness. It's your ability to be hit this way and bounce right back up. It's your ability to be hit on the one side and then turn the other cheek. It's your ability to give up your shirt and then your coat.
Woo!
It's your ability to go the extra mile. Your endurance is your determination. It's your will. It's your vigor, your strength. Glory be to God. And a part of your vitality, also, which is your endurance, is your energy source. Mm. If you ain't got no energy, baby, you ain't doing nothing. Mm. Your endurance is attached. Your spiritual endurance is attached to your energy, your spiritual power, your enlightenment, your illumination, that awakening. When the Spirit of God comes down and you feel away, you're like, woo, wow, get that. I feel my help coming on. I feel my peace. I feel my joy. When you get into prayer, you get into the word, you get into speaking in tongues, the Bible says, but ye, beloved, building up yourself on your most holy faith, praying in the Holy Ghost. I feel myself going down, so let me get in tongues. I challenge you Begin to speak in tongues and watch your endurance. Your level goes up. Your enlightenment goes up. Your strength, your vitality, your energy, everything goes up. Oh, to God. So your energy source is your fuel from your own will to live. Many people have lived because of their will to live.
Right.
Many of them die because they lost their will to live.
That's right.
And God has given them the chance. You want to live? Let's show you. Let me see your endurance. Let me see how willing you willing to keep on paddling until you paddle yourself on up out of this creek. That's that dog, tenacious attitude. A vivacious way that you go. I ain't dying. The devil is a lie.
That's right.
Oh no, I ain't going down like that.
Yeah.
I'm gonna fight. My endurance is pushing me. It's egging me on.
Yeah.
Now how about I'm loving you?
Man.
Your endurance will cause you to soar. Glory be to God. And it'll cause you to live. You build on that as you progress in faith. Your endurance. We need endurance so we can build according to what God's pattern. And the God kind of endurance comes from the word. We see this word and we grab hold to it and we want nothing but the word. Glory be to God. And so our thoughts and everything become centered and it becomes shaped and molded and formed into what God says. So what God says becomes gospel. It becomes alive. It becomes rhema. It becomes well with our soul. And then we begin to fortify. And that causes our faith to be unshakable. God's way of being and doing does not run parallel with this horizontal way of living. Because the horizontal way of living is full of holes. It's full of hypocrisy. It's full of apostasy. It'll push you out of the things of God. It'll make you run out and cheat on God. It's full of conspiracy. It's full of debate and deceit and wickedness. It's full of every diabolical influence you can even think of. So keep looking horizontal if you want. You want to better turn your eyes up. When you look to the right and left, you see sin. You better look up.
Yes, Lord.
You know you ain't strong enough to deal with something. You better shut up and look up. Don't be trying to, I'm just trying to help them out. Ain't nobody tell you to help them out. You need to get your endurance intact first so you can stand, because you get on the wrong ship if you want to, you're going under. See, this is how the devil fools so many people, and they start off with God. You ran well, but what kindred you? You didn't use wisdom. Wisdom would have told you, no, baby, leave that alone. Come over here.
Yeah.
You're working on something.
Yeah.
And you, when you're working on something, you understand that you can't move out in the caverns of the earth until God release you to do that. Mm-hmm. Don't go under no tree talking about witnessing to somebody, and then you was under there last week. Go get your endurance first.
Yeah.
And tell them, I was here 6 months ago. Y'all remember me? But I'm back. I'm back with my armor now. Stand up there bad and bold. You ready now. You got your endurance. You got your strength. You got your weaponry. It's all intact and it's ready because you know some sneaky stuff coming. You know some stuff is coming. So this time, your endurance is intact. Glory be to God. And so seeing in this life, seeing is believing. So you can't follow what this world deems as what is right and what is gospel. This is what's getting us trapped up in our faith. We're looking horizontally too much. Because in a horizontal way, seeing is believing. And it'll cause you to be torn between God and the world and feeling like a fool. But in Christendom, believing is not seen.
Yeah,
faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. And so if you lazy and don't want to get in his word, you can see that. That's key. You can see, but it's in the word. So that means you got to get in his word and allow his word to get in your soul and pull it out. So the manifestation of what God's pattern is will come before you the right way and not the wrong way. So we don't want to look around in this world. So we need our faith tested to be sure that we are getting it. Remember we said what a test is? It tests your reliability, the establishing of something. Have what you've been learning been established in your mind? Because if it is, you're going to remember it, right? You learn about a new project on the job. Okay, let's test you and see if you got it. Let's see if this protocol is established here. And then you go still doing it your way. They're like, mm-mm. You ain't got that. I'm telling you how this thing gonna go up in hell. And you are still doing it your way. This is what God's saying to the church.
Yeah, wow.
I'm telling you how this thing gonna go. Uh-huh. And it's in the word. So I'm gonna keep taking you around that rat race. Counting all joy when you knowing that the testing of your faith work is patient. So I'm gonna let you still go on so your endurance. And how about some of us that did the same test 100 times? We supposed to be moving from one test to another, not staying there. Keep, we don't miss that test, done failed it again. So we need our faith tested. Remember, like I said, the testing is to establish something. Glory be to God. Foundation is the infrastructure, structure, which is the communication. Foundation of anything is a communication to the overall durability of what you got. Build something on the sand and see how far it goes. If that thing ain't being made cement, it ain't gonna last. We use sand to build brick and mortar, but we done add something to it to call that endurance, to make that building stable. So your foundation is the overall durability of something. In the parable of the 10 virgins, remember the story? All were versions, but the overall mindset of the two different groups displayed itself in a crucial time. Uh-huh. You know how they say the proof is in the pudding? When the rubber meet the road, when the mess hit the fan, when you're between a rock and a hard place. That's when the truth, they all were versions. But the test, that crucial test, showed what they had in them. Five had oil. Five were full of the anointing. That when the end came, they were ready. And then there were five that took what they thought what they knew they should have had, they took it lightly. Guess who they were banking on to get them? Mm-hmm. The one that they knew had. I mean, were they able to get any help? No. You see why you need to look up. Your faith needs to be attached to God. And I know Pastor gonna come through for me. I know she's gonna pray for me today. I know she's gonna say hallelujah. Did you say hallelujah for me today, man? Did you say thank you, honey? Did you pray for me today?
Wow.
Wife, did you pray for me, wife? No, pray for yourself. Mama, did you? I know my mama praying for me. What about you? Because when judgment time comes, you won't God say, I don't know you. Matter of fact, I ain't know you. Your mama knew you. And I knew what your mama was praying for, but I tapped you on the shoulder. Other times and tried to get you to come to me for yourself and you just wouldn't come. I just couldn't get you to come. So that which is not, it was the foolish took the things of God lightly. It wasn't important to them, in other words. It wasn't valuable. The things that you take lightly are the things that are not valuable to you. You know how you walk over things in the flow? Walk over a piece of paper. That ain't valuable to me, so I just step on the paper. God ain't valuable to me, so I don't talk to him. Worship ain't valuable. Prayer ain't valuable. Loving others ain't valuable, so I don't love them. I just let them see my ugly side when I need to. And God don't convict me. Convict. God, well, you should have seen what they did to me. Some folk talk to God just like that.
Yeah.
That which is not valuable to you, and we're talking about your faith, you're not willing to go through with it. You just ain't willing to take this test. You ain't willing for the challenges. Matter of fact, you went MIA on the test. And God got that big upsell again. That's why folk run from churches to church. They go over here and then give them 8 months. They over there. And then some of them come right back to what it was before. Hey, it's stopping again. Don't again. Because they're running from the test. They running for, they ain't know that flesh gotta be tested. It gotta be tried. It gotta see if you gonna really run up, you really want this word. Let's see if you really wrong. So you will not fall through with it. You got to evaluate your tenacity of your faith, the strength. Are you really holding on? The strength, the durability, the reliability of your faith. If your faith is shaking, you will not have the substance to carry you safely when the floods of life coming, not if, when it comes. If your faith is shaking, you're going to be screaming, hollering, crying, oh Lord, you know, you ain't hear what they say. In this test we get ready to talk about, you got to be willing to say, okay, God, if I go down sin, God is still able.
Amen.
So our goal here is to obtain, which is to get whole, in order that we can maintain wholeness in our spirit, soul, and body as sons of Abraham. And in order to do that, we need our faith. Fourth verse of James 1. Then it says, so let it grow. For when your endurance is fully developed, you will be perfect and complete, needing nothing. I love that. You mean tell me I can fortify this thing till I can begin to soar? You mean tell me I can get rid of the frustration? I can get rid of keep running into dead ends? So let it, the Bible say. Let it. When I look at the word telling us to let it grow, it tells me that I am in direct control of strengthening my own determination. Say with me, I am in direct control of strengthening my own determination. So it's personal. How do you let it? By letting the word and being willing to submit to it. By letting the word be what it is and receiving it. And you're submitting to it. That means I'm willing to do it. That's how I let it. So let it grow. I let it grow. You can't let it grow till you know the word. You got to hide the word in your heart. You got to abide in the word, and the word abide in you. When the word abide in you, you are letting it grow, my Lord. You got to let it grow by being in communication with God, meaning talking to him. Talking to him is simply what? Prayer. Then in a time of worship, and when Mr. Opportunity come knocking, not on him. If Mr. Opportunity come knocking by it, no. I'm going to tell you this, and you can pass this on the test. It is not if. He is coming. When the opportunity comes to develop, when the circumstances attached to his hip come running in your face, You got to be ready to face your God lion. When this opportunity comes, drama comes. Trouble comes. Challenges come. You try me, comes. God say, yes. Are you going to sharpen your little walk in this one?
My God, Jesus.
Are you going to work on your skills and your lying and your cheating in this? Okay, the opportunity came for you to tell the truth. Is you going to tell the truth? Or are you just going to lie? That's not an opportunity. Somebody asks. And you're supposed to tell on yourself. Even if it's to your own hurt. And the hood I'm talking about is self.
It's supposed to be dead, y'all. Yeah? So why not we want to tell the truth to the hood, the self? Stop protecting it. It's killing you.
Well, I'm going to help you a little bit. Say, Lord, I believe.
Lord, I believe.
Help my unbelief.
Lord,
I believe.
Help
my unbelief.
Lord,
I believe.
Help
my unbelief. In other words, Lord, I believe if I do this, I'm going to come out as pure gold. I believe that I'm going to come out on top. I believe I'm going to be able to love my neighbor. I believe that I'm going to be able to be honest. I believe that I'm going to be truthful. I believe that the character of God going to shine through me. I believe that I'm going to be able to win the loss at any cost. I believe that the earth is God and the fullness thereof. I believe that I'm going to be able to embark upon some of this earth. And God's going to be able to trust me with some of it so I can use it for the moment of building his kingdom. That's what it all boils down to.
Hallelujah.
Lord. And we don't come up. Then God can't use us. Imagine this. Think about the story of the prodigal son. God gave him everything. What he did? He squandered it. You see it? Because he didn't have any resolve, he had no faith, he had no strength, no integrity, he had no character. He didn't even know his purpose. He knew nothing. That's why he got rid of everything he thought he wanted it. And he really got to understand, you know what? I didn't know what to do with all this stuff. Now since I done lost it all, I'm over here eating with the pigs. That's what sin will do. Sin will usher you right to the pig slop. And you slopping trying to eat the hub when your father is over there with a mansion. You done took yourself from the palace to the pit. You did that. You see how serious that is? Isn't that scary too? So your unbelief has to be challenged head on. You got to be willing to take the sword of the spirit and go ahead and open your mouth with this word and cut that thing dead. Kill it. Cut unbelief down. You got to begin to cut fear. Cut that addiction down. Cut that lust off. You got to be willing to cut it. Cut it. Stab it. Just like the man of God went in the tent. When they was in sin and stabbed them people. And you're like stabbing sin. You got to get fed up with that mess using you. Because it plagues your whole household, your family. Everybody on the same boat. Why y'all got so many lying people in your family? You got to watch who you talk to, young people. Check out their mama, them, their auntie, uncle. Use everything as a signal.
That's right.
I wish somebody would have told me. Everybody need to be tested. Everybody. You better believe I'm talking about. And you better believe the Holy Ghost is leading me. Because everybody, including me, too. You think I'm out of this race? No. So you got to open your mouth and deal with this thing and let the word that you allow to be sown and penetrated and saturated in your soul to come and cut out everything that hinders your growth. You got to let it grow. Let it. This how you let it grow. By getting on the offense.
That's right.
I ain't defending you no more, self. I'm not defending lust no more. Stop defending your lies. And get on the offense and say, you know what, you're right, I did lie. I was upset with you. I did not like you. You did. I did thought you stole my stuff. Tell the truth. I'm ashamed of them. Hey, matter of fact, I saw him laying back like this. I'm like, boy, if you don't get off that couch in between the two pillows, ain't get that's an inside joke, y'all. That's a wholeness empowerment ministry joke on Pastor Lewis. My Lord, that's just how it went. Oh my God. Leg crossing off. I'm going to let you out to you tomorrow. Why you don't get over here? Oh my Lord. It's like, help me, Jesus, and nephew. I'm sorry. I'm so sorry, you know. It was funny though. I laughed for a good little while. So we got to cut unbelief down and we got to let it grow. My Lord, its development has a full potential. Your growth. He said, let your endurance fully grow, fully develop. You don't see the beauty of that sunflower until it fully develops.
That's right.
And then it opens up and you be like, oh, look at the beauty. Look at that yellow and wow, look at the middle. You see that beauty of that fully developed plant, flower. Meaning it fully matures. You gotta let it move and capacitate to its full expansion. That means don't stop that. Don't let sin stop. Stop.
Right.
We were working on something. Why you stop that?
Right.
You gotta let other stuff, you gotta stop letting stuff shipwreck your faith and your growth. You see the wings, an eagle's wing have to develop in order that they work to the capacity to not just fly, but see, a chicken got wings. Are you hearing me today? Chicken got so many wings till it's ridiculous. But yet their wings is just like a flap of noise. And they can get on top of something and jump down as far as they go. But it's something about an eagle's wing. That they don't just fly, but they soar. My Lord, glory to God. So don't get it twisted. You can have wings in the wings of the world and sin and think that you're going to soar like an eagle, but yet you can't go nowhere because you got on the wrong wings. Your perception is wrong. Your intentions is wrong. Meaning your motives is wrong. Your trust and faith and test is wrong. You failed, but yet you're trying to soar. That's when frustration comes in. And like, every time I try to do right, I end up down there with it in the dirt. Because you dirt beget dirt. Because you're wallowing in it now. There's some things you missed out on. I mean, you could have came back and got a better score on that test if you would have took the bonus part. You didn't know you had 100 points that, towards the bonus, but you skipped around the bonus part that God told you to do. So you completely fail the test. Sometimes we ace it. Sometimes we get a little less grade, but we ain't failed it. That means we're still in the race. And then sometimes we totally fail it. Then we become torn between two levels, feeling like a fool trying to make this thing work. And it's not working because we're using the wrong vehicle. Our wings are the wings of Christ. And we soar in the things of God beyond our own ability. We soar up out of, I've been called out of darkness into with marvelous light. Meaning who? Do what? You ain't talking to me. I don't do that. But some of us gonna answer, yeah, I did used to do that. Oh, I got an opportunity to do it again. You ain't do that in 20 years. Don't go back to crack cocaine and dope and lust after 20 years of being free. Is that not crazy? Because of some situation happening, they didn't understand that it was an opportunity for them to really see that I'm getting over this thing. But yet, they failed the test. And they went back and answered it. They wanted it. It was in there. It was in them. Somewhere they miss it. So I say that to say this. You can't tap into things of God and go, I'm a leaver. I'm going to do God today. And tomorrow I might do God. But the other 5 days are mine. Wow. You can't take this thing or your faith is not going to work. You got to work your faith Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and back to Sunday. As a matter of fact, what you do on Sunday don't count. Is what you do outside the four walls of the church. That's what counts. That's the part that builds your endurance. When you're alone. But you're not alone. Why? Because God is with you, child of God. He's encouraging you. He's telling you to go ahead. You can do it. You are more than a conqueror. You just need to know it. You just need to know that you are.
Know it. That's right.
You just need to know it. Because self is keeping. No, you ain't. You just need to get over here in this dirt. No, I'm more than a conqueror. I'm an eagle.
Right.
I don't do dirt stuff no more. I've been called out of darkness into his marvelous light. Glory to God. Glory be to God. As the scriptures say, he who began a good work in you shall perform it. And it does not mean that Jesus is going to perform it. I'm just going to sit around and just keep tweeting. Don't get that twisted. He's talking about the work that he did is already done. Your strengthening of your endurance and your resolve is your receiving of what has already been done. He has done a good work and you shall perform it. Meaning the performance has already been done. I just need you to agree with it so we can come into a you know what I'm saying? Husband and wife can't marry till both parties say yeah. So they go home together and they be a couple. You understand me? Jesus already said yes. He already paid for everything that pertains to life. Your blessing, all everything is already done. It's just your part needs to come up to where he is to connect. So the manifestation of that thing, that what Christ has already done, could be fulfilled, could be brought to a full wholeness, a developed fruition, is what I'm saying. To its fullness, that you will not be missing anything. And so the benefit of enduring through the test brings you to an opportunity of perfection. Did you hear that? Stop letting yourself stumble out. When you hear folks, I'm like, ain't nobody perfect. That's their excuse, baby. They ride on that. Folks love that. Myself, too. Self, don't you like that? Mm-hmm. I'm telling you the truth. Because it give me a moment to cut up when I want to. And ain't nobody going to always do it right here. Self is doing, what you call them? Cartwheels. Oh, say that again. Ain't nobody good. Now this is what we're gonna do. Logos gotta come back alive. I feel logos coming on. Really? Good. Cause I had some things back here. I had some tricks in my bag. I just waiting to use them. And you know what? You just helped me out. I love you. You ain't gonna love me because you're gonna run up into this word. The Bible says you will be perfect and complete, needing nothing. Meaning your perfection that you are gonna walk in is gonna be in Christ and not in you.
That's right.
And you don't have the opportunity to walk in Christ today and tomorrow ain't walking in Christ.
Amen.
If you play with God, that way you'll get burned. You know what they say? You play with fire, you get burned. God knows your intention, your motive. You can't get around. I'm going to walk in Christ today, but tomorrow, that time coming. I ain't walking in Christ. That's why the Bible says walk in the spirit and you will not fulfill the lust of the flesh. Period. Can I add anything else to that?
No.
So your premeditated stuff, grace don't cover that foolishness. That's you cooking up stuff. That's what it's called, witchcraft. You cook that up and you plan to go do that. Premeditate. They lock you up for that, boo. They put your behind in jail. And if the world have enough to sense to put you in jail for stuff you sat around and you meditated, you use your head. And then you go over there.
My God.
Shall man seeing that great smell battle? God forbids that. So God knows when we want to be genuine with him. It takes our faith. Say with me, it takes my faith. To be genuine with God. And the reason being because your faith will cause you to have confidence and trust in God. Knowing that the work that Christ has already did is what's going to do it for you. You just need to receive it. You don't have enough power to do this thing on your own. It is in Christ alone. Amen. Stand to your feet. And we'll finish with that part, that intro, that's like an introduction to what a test is all about. Next week, we'll go into Hebrews, the 11th chapter. We'll get into that 8th verse, and we'll see Abraham as an example, how God called him to leave his place of familiarity to go to a place that he didn't even know he was going. So that was his test. We'll get into that test next week. Father, we just thank you for the word, Lord. The word is always good, Father. And we refuse not to regurgitate the word, Father God. But we choose.